Hey, I'm WOODKID, and you're watching Highsnobiety TV. Well, my name is WOODKID. I'm from Paris. I'm a video director and a musician. And I'm here to promote my first album, The Golden Age. Whatever I feel for you, you only seem to care about you. This tiny chance you can see me too, 'cause I love you. I talk about The Golden Age as childhood. The first track of the album is called The Golden Age, but it's a very cynical title because what I say in that song is the golden age is over. In that song, I talk about that moment where, as a child, you step away from home, you walk through the door, and you start to become an adult. I create these stories with like missing pieces. Missing pieces are very interesting because then people want to fill them. People are afraid of emptiness and they want to fill these gaps. And when you wanted to find an explanation about it, you went to check out about this skull thing and this same thing. And that's exactly what I want to do with my art, is I want people to think about what they see and wonder if what they see is real, if what they see has a meaning, and we'll want to try to look for something. Whatever I feel for you, you only seem to care about you. This tiny chance you can see me. I know I'm very lucky because I have been making pretty much a good amount of money with WOODKID that I've been able to reinject into videos, and that I do my videos myself, so I have a lot of people working for free. But at the end, the budgets of the video are much bigger than any other indie artists. And I always feel uncomfortable announcing numbers about this because I feel sorry for all the artists that ask that type of budgets to their record companies, and the record companies can't afford to pay that amount of money. But also because our marketing plan is to put everything on the music videos and not put marketing money on the rest, and be confident that the videos are going to be the only tool for us to talk about my music. But I think it's healthy because instead of, you know, spending my money in coke or, you know, going out at night, paying cars, you know, getting prostitutes and just, you know, going on holidays and business class everywhere in the world. Instead of doing that, I just put my money back in my project. Run, boy, run. This world is not meant for you. Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you. Run, boy, run. Running is a victory. Run, boy, run. Beauty lies behind the hills. When I did Run, Boy, Run, we shot a grizzly bear in the video, and for some reason it happened not to be working in the edit. So I never used the footage of the grizzly bear, which sounds crazy. The owner of the grizzly bear, it cost us so much money to have the grizzly bear in this video. And the owner was like, what the fuck? Why isn't it in the edit? And I was like, I'm sorry, I made a mistake. As a director, I made a mistake. I wrote that idea, but it didn't work. So we didn't use the grizzly bear at the end. And I was like, wow, I just had a grizzly bear come one day and shoot, and I paid amounts of money for that, and I didn't use it in the edit at the end. But that was a good lesson for me, because it's also, as a director, you have to accept that sometimes you make wrong decisions. And it's not because they did cost money that you have to use them at the end in the edit. Sometimes you have to let go of things that seem important. You have to forget about the shooting. You have to forget that that it's not because it's been very hard to get an image that it's a good image. Sometimes very, very easy image are the ones you have to use because they're the ones that make sense in what you want to say. Well, in the near future, you can expect probably another WOODKID video, maybe by the end of the year. That would probably be a bigger one. It's going to be like a conclusion, and probably the last one. That's going to just like start to put all these puzzle pieces together a little bit. I'm still going to leave some from seeing the open, so people keep on thinking about it. And right now I just moved back to New York because I'm studying screenwriting and cinema history, because I'm studying working on my first feature film. But it's not going to be soon because I have a tour to make. And my priority right now is to promote this album and on stage and, you know, connect with the people who hopefully are going to buy the album and just love it. And I want to give them a little bit of the live experience from that. So I would say next year is going to be a lot about being on tour and studying and trying to be somebody new again.